Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's go to next level rockets barrel ride. Be on the lookout for stuff that's hidden around everywhere. It's one of those sorts of vertical levels that they like to hide stuff in very awkward places. By the way, that's a crumple there. And he's pretty much invulnerable to most stuff here, except for Kitty Kong. Yeah, he needs the extra weight to squish him, I suppose. Anyway, these are rocket barrels. They shoot you up. Yep, like that. If you ever should fall down, they just, you know, they reset position there. So it's not like you're in a spot that you can't go back or anything like that if you lose track of, I mean, if you fall from a rocket barrel or something like that. And also, you're able to go behind these waterfalls like that if you take these upper paths. So there's going to be like multiple pathways through this level too. So yeah, a lot to explore here. I'm going to go on this side just because there's nothing here. Okay, just wanted to make sure. Oh, I think I dropped the gun, or jumped in the gun too quick. Oh, the arrow's telling me to go this way, so I should probably go that way. I figured that there might be something hidden off to the sides, you know, so I'm trying to explore every level as I go, like there's some bananas there. Is it K? That's good. I hope I didn't need a partner. That's kind of cheap. Because they're just like right there in my face. Oh, no, no, no. 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 Yes. Oh, and there's... What? Are you guys just going to like cheaply pop off from the sides the entire level? Because if so, that would be kind of mean. Yeah, yeah, yeah. they make that sound when... Yeah. Oh, I mistimed it. They make that sound when you jump on them with something that does not kill them. Please don't jump from the side. Please. Please. Okay. I should say, please don't come out of the side there, crimp. Thank you. Wait a second. Wait a second. Hold on. Hold on. Oh, the letter O is there. Just wanted to make sure there wasn't a bone. Wait, wait, hold on a sec. I see what they're doing. Watch this. There is something down... Oh, here. Yeah, there are those knickknacks there to lead you to it if you didn't have Dixie. So, yeah, here we go. Can I make it within 15 seconds? Oh, shoot. That's not good. That's not good. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, wait, there's stars off to the left, too. I didn't see them on the wall. Oh, shoot. Well, I can tell that they give you ample amounts of time for that one because I really messed around a lot there. Where am I? Yep, here we go. Yeah, I figured that was the ledge that I was just on. Rematch versus the bonus game. I was not looking ahead very well. That's why I didn't really see the stars ahead of time. Yeah, it makes things so much easier, doesn't it? And there we go. Oh boy, still much more level to go. Much more danger to be had. Much more pain to be upheld. Hopefully not, though. what's behind here if I go there? Oh, a bear coin, I suppose. But that's not going to help me progress. I wonder if I should kill him off, just in case I fall back down. You never know in this game. This game can be pretty mean. Oh, yeah! Just remember to hold the direction that you want to go before you... there's Perry, by the way, before you hit said spot so that you get maximum distance when you move. Oh, this is kind of tricky. I don't think you have to bring Perry to the end, but if you do, you'll get a prize for it. I should say if you... Oh! Both of us lost! Holy mother of pearl, it's fast getting back here. And I didn't take any hits along the way either, so that's good. Alright, made it. Mate, oh. Woo! Please, Perry, you can make it. I believe in you. I want to see what prize you have, because I forgot what prize you have. Ugh. Okay, doing well. Still exploring. Safely. But still exploring. Oh, no. Moving object with Perry. Not friendly. Where is the signpost for Perry? I got a 1-up for taking Perry there, because it was able to get up to said 1-up. Oh, please, signpost. I need you. I need you so badly. Yes! Wow, another blue balloon. Very generous. what's over here? Hello! Hello! It's 60 stars this time for this bonus game. Well, it's kind of tricky to see where the poop you are landing into, because the barrels are off-screen when you're falling, but the stars kind of point you in the right direction, so I don't think I'll have that much difficulty. Also, watch the, darker parts of the waterfall in the background there, because they seem to lead you to the, spots that the rocket barrels are as well. Oh shoot, one last chance. Oh! Okay, I shouldn't say it's one last chance, because I'm just gonna be pooped back out over here and all. Actually, where the heck am I? What if I fall? Where am I? Really? Seriously? Okay, I'm back here. This was the parry sign, and thus, oops, I need to go no, this way. And here is the bonus area. Alright, since I got an idea for the bonus area this time, I should be able to do this a lot quicker. Maybe I should have Kitty Kong for this, because of his chunk being able to collect things maybe a little bit easier. Perhaps, maybe? I don't know. I think I'm just blaming bad planning for whatever Kong I'm using. I mean, I'm blaming the Kong rather than my bad planning, excuse me. Like, see, I've got plenty of time to do it now. Just gotta... there we go. Look at that! Voila! Okay, now it's gonna poop me out in progress land, so now I can take this barrel up. Wait a second, isn't this where coin is? Yes, but how do you get them this time? I think because the barrel, Shoot. Because the barrel, what it does is it makes you... is it possible to take a hit there when you're coming into this blind? But anyway, I think the barrel, it won't bounce off the side of the screen because there is a, there's no bounce to that over there. Yeah, see, it goes right off screen. So I think what I'm gonna have to do here is... like, throw it up. Oh, no, not like that. I blame the Xbox D-pad. No, okay, I'm gonna throw it up like that, and then quickly run. Okay, that worked. Voila. Now, what does this do? Oh, I thought this was gonna take me to the end. I see what I was supposed to do. I was supposed to throw the barrel up. Not like that. But I was supposed to throw the barrel up and use the cannon to get behind him before the barrel got to him. Like that. Yeah, that would have been perfect. Whoopsie doodle. Oh, well, it worked out. Anyway, yeah, this is the end of the level here. And it's 100%. Wow, that actually took me longer than I thought it would. Jeez. Wrinkly save game. Let's save our game and see what she has to say this time. Oh. She's playing video games. Shh, okay. I'm on my last life and you're breaking my concentration. By the way, if you can't tell, the music in the background is, the Peach's Castle theme from Super Mario 64, or at least I think that's where it came from, because I don't remember hearing this theme in games before Super Mario 64. Well, you know, besides this, but what I mean is that it turned out to be the main theme for Peach's Castle, and it might have been put in this game as sort of like a reference to the next gen, because Donkey Kong Country 3 came while the N64 and games were in development already, so it's possible that they were doing this ahead of time. And also, if you look over there, that looks a lot like an N64 over there, so perhaps she's playing Super Mario 64, perhaps it's just a reference, who knows. Anyway, I'm gonna save my game here. I've been burning a lot of time in this single save area. Okay, I will. Besides, you can't beat me anyway. Alright, I think I'm gonna do one more level here, because I only did one level so far. Oh, this one's an ugly one to do when you have the toughest code on, because it's a genuinely difficult level. Creeping Klasps. You've got these climbing TNT barrels, and what they do is they explode if they touch you, and well, that's a big problem because you gotta climb on the things that they are going to be also climbing on, so yeah. Hopefully I won't need both Kongs to 100% this level, but I probably will, knowing this game's evilness. Oh, there they are. That is a clasp. See that? They're TNT barrels with grabby arms. They are not friendly in the slightest. I need to get up there. Really need to get up there. Thank you. And you guys just don't want me to 100% the game, do you? Do you? Oh, and as you can also tell, there is a certain fishy in the water as well, so you can't even swim underneath them. This stage is a drastic upping of difficulty in comparison to stages in the past. I mean, Donkey Kong Country games are known to have pretty haphazard difficulty, but combining Niblas in the water with clasps on ropes, you've got a recipe for pure evil right here. So I'm going to be going as carefully as I possibly can and hope for the best. Is it worth going over to this side? Probably not, even though there's a 1-up there. But you know, since you can save any time, 1-ups are pretty much useless. Well, you can save any time you go to Cranky Save Cave. I mean, Wrinkly Save Cave, excuse me. Wait a second. Aren't I looking for a barrel? Oh, shoot. I'm looking for a barrel that leads to a bonus barrel. It's... you gotta drop down from it in the into the water. It's not really all that obvious, but it's safe to do so if you know where it is. I think it's... oh, it's here. Here it is. Okay, so what I think I'm gonna do here is go like this. And, like, see, that right there is the bonus barrel. But in order to get to that, I need to... go inside that barrel to get to the bonus barrel at the bottom left there. Or I could take a hit from a Nibla. But since I had, I only had one Kong with me, I had to go for the barrel. And, yeah, you've seen how that went. Anyway, let's just run through the stage here. And, oh, man. You know what? Restart. That's a strategic restart right there. Okay, I'm going to try and keep both Kongs going on here. In fact, I should actually have Kitty Kong out first because, you know, he's the biggest. He'll be more easily hittable, I guess you could say. So he is probably the worst choice, and thus I wouldn't be too sad if I lost him early on in the level. But, you know, he'll come back again later. But what I mean is, you know, strategically, it's a thing of... it's a thing of that I gotta pick my battles and choose Kongs based on the things that I need to use to get past stuff. Why did I go for that O? Why did I do that? I'm not aiming for all letters in this walkthrough, because they don't really give you 100% and they're risky and stuff. And though I'm pretty much coming across all letters anyway, so I don't know. I want to be in that barrel so badly. Okay, I'm gonna follow you over. Drop. Ooh, that's how it's done. Now I don't want to fail this bonus. Oh no. Why do you exist even in the bonus level? No. Have mercy. Please. Oh, yes. This level's all about the strategy, but it's still a difficult level regardless of how strategic you play, because you don't have much room for error on stuff. Like, look at this right here. You've got a buzz, and you've got a clasp. And you gotta time yourself, because you can't, like, just jump over when you get to the end. Oh no, that one's a little different, because that buzz will trap you if you aren't looking ahead. Oh! And I didn't look far enough ahead there. Okay, I need... Spawn Doom. Oh, I just need to know where you guys are. Okay, we're good. We're safe. Kind of. Sort of, maybe. There's death everywhere. There's explosives and stuff and nope. Oh, hello. I think we're at the end of the level. I think we are at the end, yes. Yes. Please tell me that I'm able to restart if I should fail this. Doesn't matter. Did I get them all? Yeah, I got them all. Woo! Another level bites the dust. And with that, I'm going to end off this part here. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you in the next part. Ah, she's done playing. I most certainly will. No, please, no. Anything but that.